So let's talk about molecular theory of gases. When you're talking about molecular theory of gases, talk about the gases' behavior when they are subjected to different temperatures and pressures. We can summarize the behavior of these gases under or into two simple different laws. Well, number one, we have the Boyle's law. And law number two, we have the Charles law. Charles law. These laws apply to ideal gases. Ideal gases are gases with negligible forces of attraction, and or negligible volumes. So let us first talk about number one. Number one, we have the Boyle's law. So Boyle's law states that the volume of a fixed mass of the gas is directly, is inversely proportional to its pressure at a constant temperature. So here we are going to be looking about three parameters. The first parameter is volume, the second parameter is pressure, and lastly, temperature. So if I denote these parameters, let volume be denoted by V, pressure be denoted by P, and lastly temperature be denoted by theta T. Representing this law mathematically, so I have mathematically we say the volume of a fixed mass of a gas V is inversely proportional to pressure. Now when we try to remove the proportionality sign, we shall have V is equal to, we introduce a constant times 1 over P, which gives us V is equal to K over P. Making K the subject of the formula, shall have V, P is equal to K. So P, V is equal to K. This is Boyle's law. So a gas that is under pressure 1 and volume 1 can be made to occupy another pressure P2 and another volume 2. So simply, I can write that as the pressure 1 and volume 1 is equal to the pressure 2 of that gas times the volume 2 of that gas. So this one is what you call the Boyle's law. Then secondly, we talk about the Charles law. Number two, have the Charles law. The Charles law states that the volume of a fixed mass of a gas is directly proportional to the absolute absolute temperature. The absolute temperature. Now, if I want to mathematically represent that, I'll say the volume is directly proportional to temperature. When I want to remove the proportionality sign, what I will do, I'll say volume is equal to kT. When I make k the subject of the formula, I get k is equal to V over T. So a gas that has this volume, 1, can be made to occupy another temperature, another volume, 2, and a temperature, 2. So I can rate that as rating the 2, so I say k is equal to V1 over T1, again is equal to V2 over T2. So if I move this curve, I have V1 is equal to V2 over T2 over T1. So I also have that one. Let me talk about the absolute temperature. The absolute temperature is where the theoretical temperature of that gas is believed to be 0 degrees Celsius. So this is called the absolute temperature. So on a Celsius scale, it can be 0 degrees Celsius, and on a Kelvin scale, it is got by adding 2. So this is the Celsius scale. So the Kelvin scale, it will be, you add 273. So I have 0 degrees Celsius plus 273. This gives us the Kelvin, which is 273 Kelvins. So this is absolute temperature in Kelvin scale. Let us talk about the ideal gas equation. When we talk about the ideal gas equation, it is got by combining the two equations, the two laws, i.e. Boyle's law, which states that, which is written as PV is equal to a constant, and then the Charles law, which states that V over T is equal to constant. So when you combine these two, we get the ideal gas equation, which is PV over T is equal to a constant. This one can be written as P1 V1 over T1 is equal to P2 V2 over T2. This is the ideal gas equation, which is used to calculate the effect of internal effect of pressure and temperature on given gases. Another example here, a certain gas occupies 211 centimeter cubed at 18 degrees Celsius and 740 millimeters of natural length. What volume will it occupy if still gaseous at negative 20 Celsius and 770 millimeters of natural pressure? So what we need to first do is to summarize our information. Have the pressure 1 is 740 millimeters of natural length, is here millimeters of mercury. Temperature 1 is 18 degrees Celsius, but we need our temperature in or on a Kelvin scale. So I add 273, it will give us 291 Kelvins. Then our volume 1, it is 211 centimeters cubed. The pressure 2 is here, is 770 millimeters of mercury. Then temperature 2 is negative 20, so I change to the Kelvin scale, which is adding 273, to give me 253 Kelvins. Then volume 2 is what is required. So here I will use our ideal gas equation, which is given by P1 V1 over T1 is equal to P2 V2 over T2. Pressure 1 is 740 times V1 to 11 divided by 291 is equal to P2 is 770 times V2 is unknown divided by T2 is 253. So when I make V2 the subject of the formula, I cross multiply, I will have 770 V2 times 291 is equal to this side of this 740 and it's 211 and it's 253. Leave V2 this side and you have V2 is equal to 740 times 211 times 253 divided by this side of this, which is 770 times 291. When I put this into the calculator, I have V2 is equal to 176 centimeters cubed as our volume 2. As example 2, we have a certain mass of the gas occupies 146 centimeters cubed at 18 degrees Celsius and 738 millimeters of mercury pressure. Calculate its volume at STP. So at STP, stand temperature and pressure, we don't know the volume. Volume 2 is equal to, we don't know that one. Temperature at STP, that is T2, is equal to, we have 273 kelvins. Then our pressure 2 is 760 millimeters of mercury. This is STP. Then the gas occupies that is V1 is equal to 146 centimeters cubed. T1 is 18 degrees Celsius, which is the same as 291 kelvins. Then pressure 1 is equal to 738 millimeters of mercury. Then when I put in our equation here, P1 V1 over T1 is equal to P2 V2 over T2. This one will give us P1 738 and V1 is 146 over T1 291 is equal to P2 is 760 times V2, which is unknown, divided by T2, which is 273. Make V2 the subject, I have 760. V2 is equal to cross multiply, then times 291 is equal to 273 times 738 times 146. So I leave V2 to that side, then I have 273 times 738 times 146 divided by this one, 760 times 291. When I put this one through the calculator, I will have 133 kelvins.